Hey guys, I was gonna do a tutorial today. I finally figured out how to do the lace pockets on shorts. I was flipping through Forever 21 and I found the cutest pair of shorts. But they had like lace pockets and like these really cute holes in the front. And I was like, oh, those are adorable. Like $25 for a pair of those shorts from Forever 21, I just didn't see it. So guess what? I finally figured out how to do it, guys. I'm going to show you how to do it today. Exciting, huh? Yeah. You should like it just because of this. But anyway, just stay tuned and let's get started. Okay, guys. What you're going to need is thread and a needle. It just depends what kind of color you want on it. Whatever goes with your shorts. It's like this. It's just kind of like an orangish, but... actually, it's more like a brown, not really orange, but I like this color a lot, so I'm just gonna use it. It's kind of like a sage green, but yeah, we'll just check it out and see what happens. You'll need a knife, preferable. You might want to rough up the edges or whatever on the ends. You don't have to have one, but it's best if you have a serrated one at the very ends like this, because it's just a lot better. Pins, you might need it, you might not, depends how good you are at sewing. And a pair of fabric scissors. Yeah. Don't cut yourself, just kidding. And of course the big finale, you'll need lace. I got this lace at Walmart. I got like 1 foot, but the girl accidentally gave me like a little bit more than a foot, so I was like, yeah. But anyway, it was only like $2, so yeah, it's not that bad at all if you're wanting to do this project. And these jeans, they used to be pants, and I made them into cute little shorts, and I started a whole lot of them, but I haven't finished them yet because I was wanting to show you guys how I did this, like the holes and the little fringe around. If y'all want a tutorial on how to make shorts, just let me know. I found my seam ripper. Okay, so first things first, we're going to cut the seams on the pockets. Now you don't have to do this, you can sew it around it. Again, it just kind of goes with how much time you have. But I actually took and ripped all the seams out of the pockets so that I can sew the lace actually in it instead of just on it. But it'll look a lot nicer. Just do whatever you please. So basically how you start is you're going to see like all these little seams on the inside of your shorts where your pocket is, right? Okay, and you're going to just pluck them in one spot until you start getting a little bit of a thing. And then you can rip open your seam right here. You'll be able to rip it open. And of course it won't be all the way open, but like you'll have a little bit at a time. And you'll just take your seam ripper and rip it and keep ripping it and keep ripping it until it's all open. And I just left this at the top simply because it'll keep it like... in place while I'm trying to sew on and stuff. And plus it's not really necessary, you can just go around that, because I just wanted to do it right here. Like I was gonna leave the very top because my lace kind of like flares at the end. It's kind of like a ruffly look. See how it like ruffles at the ends? But anyway, I didn't want to cover that up, so I was gonna do that. Okay, so once you have ripped all of the seams out of it, you need to pull all of these things out, which I'm going to do right now. So now I have taken all of the little seams out, and they're all on the floor over here, but it looks a lot better. So now what you're going to do is you're going to focus on cutting your lace around the pocket and actually making it the size that it needs to be, but do it just a little bit outward, like just a little bit over, that way you can tuck it under and then sew it. Get what I'm saying? Like, instead of cutting it exactly, you're going to leave just a little bit of room around it, that way you can sew it under. So you'll have a little bit of room. But yeah, it'll look something like that. I cut this out. Yeah, I just wanted a little bit to where it could ruffle over. That's the way it's gonna look whenever I sew it on this side. You know, you can tell it looks a lot neater. And then once you do this, you're gonna sew it like actually on it. So yeah, I just wanted to give you the base. So I just got done pinning on the side because I didn't want it to be uneven. I wanted it to like look good. So yeah, that's what I did on that. I pinned it, and now I'm just going to take my needle, and I'm going to sew through here onto the back side. So just keep it, it doesn't really have to be extremely neat, it just needs to be along the lines. And you can do it twice, or you can do it once down the middle, just kind of depends on how sturdy you want it. Okay, from now you just keep sewing. I am almost done. As you see, you just pull it through, and then you keep going. Up keep going further up onto the lace, and then you just keep sewing. See, holding the pants keeps a lot evener if you're holding it through the leg. That way you can just sew on through. And they don't have to be perfect, remember that. It'll look good no matter what you do, so whether it's like perfect or whether your stitches are like totally just wow, you know, it's not noticeable. So in the end, it doesn't really matter what your stitches look like as long as it works. And I'm not going to double it up simply because like I don't use my back pocket so much, so I just did it enough to where it would stay on and go through the washing machine. Take your pen off and keep going. Sew through. Pull through. Pull through. And keep sewing. Alright, it's kind of hard to sew when you're filming yourself. Okay, to tie it off, all I do is I go on the other side and I just take these two strings, and you just tie like little knots. It's nothing fancy, just tie it off. Pull it through, make another knot, pull it through, another knot, pull it through, and then one more. And pull it through, and then just cut the excess off. And you have a pair of lace pocketed shorts. Is that not adorable? Look at that. I think that's adorable. Ah, it's just so cute. And then I still need to do the other pocket, but I just wanted y'all to see this first pocket. So I'm just gonna leave the ends fringed like this because I really like it. This hole, all you do is you'll take the seam ripper. Yeah, I'll show y'all. All you do from here on is you take it and you'll take the seam ripper and you'll rip the ones that are up and down. So don't rip any of the ones that are going across. Okay, so you see these little ones? All right, so all you're gonna do is, sorry, it's so complicated to show you. All right, so you're gonna take the ones that are going up and down and you're just gonna rip them. All right, and you can start to see like this little hole. Oh, I wish it was focused. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, well, if you just keep doing that, it will make this hole. Remember, only do the ones that are lined like this, the up and down ones. Don't do the side to sides. So it's just like this little bitty ones. Like, just prick the ones that are going up and down. Also, another fast way to get the ripped up look is for you to take your knife, and like I said, I suggest you use a cutting board. So you're just gonna put like a folder down or something or whatever you want. Okay, so the look that you're looking for is the ripped up, and you're gonna take your knife and you're just gonna like take the slanted edge, the sharp edge, and just like pull down on it, and you can kind of start seeing pretty little roughed up. You can go all over it and you can fringe it, but I just wanted a little simple spot. If y'all want a more detailed tutorial, just let me know in the comment box and I will get more detailed with it. I'm sorry if it's a little confusing. Hey, for like the last time, but anyway, I finished the shorts and here is the final look. So let me know if you like them. Comment below, like, let me know if you want me to go further into the details of how I did it, or if you want me to do a different tutorial. I have a lot more coming for you guys, and just stay tuned. Anyway, there's the shorts. Here's the holes. They're really like roughed up. I really like it. And there's like the roughed up on the bottom. And then there's the pocket. Ain't it adorable? I just love it. The cute pocket. Cute. But they fit really good.